So, well over a year ago, I would, without clicking on the video, I would probably say closer to 2 years-ish now. I distinctly remember in my doing my Remus makeup video that I said soon I would be doing a video on how I did Janus's cosplay makeup. Well, better late than never. Hi. To be completely honest, it's been quite some time since I have cosplayed Janus. Because Janus is my favorite Sandersides character, I don't know about you, there's some people, it's just like, if you have a favorite character, or if you simp for a character, like, they're cosplay them, it's just like, yes. I find it very hard to cosplay my favorite characters because I have such a high standard for them that when I see myself in the outfit, it just doesn't live up to my expectations and I don't feel as good. It's kind of the reason why I'm not so inclined to cosplay Shigaraki anymore, because I love him so much that when I put on a Shigaraki cosplay, I don't really feel that great. I know this one is not the cat eye contact, but I don't really have no reason to use cat eye contacts. I will never ever use them except for probably Janus. So it would just be a waste of money to buy those kind of contacts for me. So I just stick with these. I will put on my base makeup and I will come back. I'm missing a few things. I'm all over the place. It's been... Also, clearly, I don't have eyebrows. You probably have to look up a eyebrow covering video. I could obviously cannot help you with that. my advice would be like, just shave it off. It's gonna grow back anyways. I know I look extra pasty right now, but once everything is said and done, it will look a little bit better. I'm gonna draw my eyebrows now, and then we're gonna contour. Obviously, just fill in your eyebrows or do nothing to your eyebrows. I'm assuming most of you probably have eyebrows. Also, if you don't have eyebrows and you, for whatever reason, like, I don't know, whenever I attempt to do normal guy-ish cosplay makeup, however you want to tag it, sometimes I get self-conscious because I'm like, those eyebrows should be more realistic, and whatever other critique I have for myself that day. There are eyebrow tattoos. I'm not using these because I figured I figured out I didn't like the shape really for my face in whatever context, so I'm not using those right now. But if you're having trouble drawing on your eyebrows, are great. There's a lot of different styles and they last a long time. One con is that even powdering them, they still look a little bit shiny, teeny bit. The eyebrow pen I am using is the NYX Lift and Snatch Eyebrow Pen. And every time I try to do a different eyebrow shape, it always kind of ends up kind of the same. One of the better eyebrows, I think. Contour, which I don't really know. You better go back to sleep. I'm not opening that door for you. For the contour, I'm going to be using the Lunatick Cosmetics Labs version 1 contour palette. I depotted it. I turned it into an actual notebook and it's currently on my shelf. I think it's right there. Nope, a little bit over here. I'm gonna be mixing these two colors, which they need to make they need to mix those two colors, because that's like the perfect contour color for me. And, you know, I'm just gonna go, you know, around my chin, make me look a little bit less like an egg. Not contour headphones. I'm gonna be doing on my temples as well, and usually when I do guy makeup, it's not really guy makeup, to make me really look more masculine. I've tried multiple different looks. I've even tried no makeup or no eye makeup and shit, and it just looks fucking horrible on me. Accentuating and putting contour right in here. So that's what I'm doing. That's another thing too, is that I'm going to slightly contour my forehead. One thing I do with my Janus cosplay that I don't do with the rest of my Sandersides is I don't wear the brown wig. And that's because I cannot fit it underneath the bowler hat. It just is too snug and just does not look right. I'm trying to trying to help my forehead. I don't really contour my forehead that much. I don't really pay attention to the forehead, which I should because I hate my forehead, and especially when you have no eyebrows, makes your forehead look even bigger. With my guy makeup, I try to use the same colors I used for contour because I'm not trying to look make it look like I'm really, well, again, I'm obviously wearing makeup. I don't do natural, no makeup makeup. Sticking to the same tones to make it look like I'm not wearing makeup. It's my actual shadow. Holy shit, I put way too much. That's way too much. Oh no. Stick to the same tones I use for contouring. Oh no. Okay, big blend. Big blend. I'll stick to a lighter color in here, put that over here. Maybe that'll lighten it up. It kinda did. Okay. I use the contour in my crease. I usually darken up my inner corner on my face, at least when you brighten up my inner corner with a white eyeshadow or especially like a highlight shimmery color, it looks a little more on the feminine side. So on my face, I try to blow out my bottom lid and darken my inner corner a little bit more. That is brown, yes. Now since I have such a dark color on my waterline, it doesn't blend that well, so I'm gonna take a brown eyeshadow, whatever brown you wanna use, and I'm just putting that kind of where I put the eyeliner and dragging it out slightly. So I just don't want a harsh eyeliner line. And also the eyeliner is kind of patchy too, so at least it makes it look a little bit neater. I want to keep my lid not shimmery, so I'm just going to, I'll stick with the same brush. I'm just going to take a lighter eyeshadow, place that on my lid. Maybe take some brown, put that over it. It won't be as harsh of a, or as intense of a brown since there's something sticky added to it. Taking some brown eyeshadow and just putting it kind of in the very outer corner just to deepen it up just slightly. I can't do light natural makeup. I just can't. Maybe it's just because I don't really like my face, so I try to cover it up, which kind of defeats the point of me kind of growing and doing cosplay, because I mentioned before how I did cosplay to cover myself up because I didn't like myself, but eventually over time I've learned to actually kind of like myself. It's a very slow moving process. Wow, this is maybe not what I wanted to talk about. I'm taking the brown eyebrow pen and I'm using that as eyeliner. Don't want a very harsh black, just the tiniest wings. You're not trying to enhance your eyelashes, you're just trying to darken them, which if you already have dark eyelashes, then you know, a little less work you have to do. But as you can tell, I have very blonde hair, eyelashes and shit. I mean, that's one of the reasons why I shaved my eyebrows. It's just so blonde, you can't freaking see it. When I first shaved on my eyebrows, it took my parents like a good month-ish to realize I shaved off my fucking eyebrows. I mean, I don't know if you can tell like from my camera, but can you really tell I have eyelashes on this eye? Probably it's not that clear. I'm going to pop on a highlight, which I know I said I usually keep my highlights. It seems more feminine, whatever. But that's for the eyes. Since getting really into highlighting, I like to highlight my cheeks as much as I can. We will stick with gold highlight because I still like me some colored highlight. Also, I really like how it looks when it's underneath the scales over on this side too. I use iridescent eyeshadows for highlight, and the ones I use are from Fabled Fragrances. I've also noticed if you really want your highlight to pop, just use your fingers. And you know what? I'll do a little bit right here. You know, I'm totally contradicting myself what I said earlier about the highlight, but I can't stop. Oh, that's another thing too. I always forget the little nose thing, which I probably should do now. Oh, it tickles. Also, I'm going to put red in my waterline. I'm using Chaotic Cosmetics, like, twisted eyeliner. It's a red eyeliner. I'm sticking to the Lunatick Cosmetics Labs contour palette, and I'm basically dipping into all the blush shades, maybe except for the lightest one, and just slowly, you know, building up and getting deeper and deeper and deeper before I dip into, you know, red. But I really tried to enhance, like, the inner and outer socket. I don't know. I really like how it looked. And I stick to that before I dip into the scales. So start big with lightest and then slowly get smaller. Hopefully this turns out all right. For this side too, I'm kind of just sticking to my natural eye socket. So we're, you know, where my eye, like, you know, naturally sinks in. You can see the little crease right there, and it sinks in, and my cheek puffs out right here. And kind of bringing up, again, everyone's face is a little bit different, but basically where, I think this is basically where my natural eyebrow, the underneath starts, where my eyebrow is, where I normally put my highlight. That's kind of where the, where it blends, where it fades into my, you know, foundation. So that's kind of like the stopping point of me blending. Kat, if you fall asleep for the next, like, 2 hours, I promise I will play with you so much when I'm done. I love you. Filling up my whole eye, and then I'm taking the darkest blush color in the contour palette, and I'm going to start with deepening up the outer corner and the inner corner. But now I'm going to start dipping into this very, very deep, like, reddish brown, which is Mighty Roar from Menagerie Cosmetics. Actually, I'm pretty sure now that I'm using this that I used a purple. Oh, it has to be a purple. I feel like it's a purple, but I'm still putting this color on the outer corner, and then I'll dip into the purple so at least matches a little bit. Okay, I'm adding a bit of red, and then I'm gonna blend like crazy. This is actually looking pretty good. I'm just gonna pop in this very light highlight, yellow shade, and the very, it's not that big of a difference, but just to make it pop. Doesn't really need to bump, but I kinda like it. Now I'm going to that little mouth thing that every time I've done this, I always forget about it. I'm using the red eyeliner. I think the shape I did is slightly different to Janus's shape. I think I added a little fang-like thing. So I'm starting kind of in the middle-ish area right there. And then I kind of stop, and then I start drawing out here. And that's curving. Oh god, don't fuck up. Curving slightly, bringing it up. Okay, maybe, oh no. Okay, not exactly, but kind of. I probably should have gone, like, stopped earlier right down here and went down and then there, but, you know, it's good enough. I'm going to trace this line with some water-activated face paint. Badass stencils. No, seriously, they're called... this one's not the right one, but it's still the same brand, Baddest Stencils. Yes, I think this one is just like generic snakeskin. I think they have like I know they have a few, but they're all snake skin, so it really doesn't matter. I know his scales, someone pointed out, I think a while ago on Tumblr, that his scales are technically brown, but everyone just draws them green, doesn't green. I like green better, so I'm sticking with that. If anything, try to find like a nice olivey green. So it's like a brown green, you know, meat in the middle. I will probably be sticking to this green color, which is, oh, I don't know how to pronounce that. It's not boba, but it makes me want to say boba. You could also use water activated face paint. What I did in one look a while ago, which I really enjoyed, but it was a pain to do, is after I applied all the scales with the stencil, I took a very shimmery green and highlighted a lot of them. That took forever. It looked cool, but I don't want to ever do that again. Also, don't leave a bit of space between the eye, like for the scales, the eye shadow around the eye, and a small space on like the mouth area. So also, I don't know if any of you are usually do that, but I tend to use my my pants to like wipe brushes on instead of like a towel or anything. So actually, in between each use of this, I'm taking off leftover eyeshadow and just rubbing it on my pant leg. As you can tell from my work desk, whenever, if you ever see any of my crafting videos, I don't keep things clean for very long. Clothing is no exception. Taking my usual lipstick shade, which is Lunatick Cosmetics Labs Coven Cream. I take my finger and like blend on the edges so it's not as harsh. Ooh, one thing I want to do, I think it would look cool. I think I'll take the taupe because I'm not wearing a dark lipstick, but I've done it a few times with dark lipstick when I'm wearing my green one. It's when I'm point the outer corner. Makes it look, elongates my lips and kind of makes it like a pointy. A little bit mischievous or whatever the fuck you want to call it. Okay, I don't know if that looks cool or not, but we already did it. So I don't have the whole thing on just yet, but I don't think I've shown everyone, at least talking in video, because versus, or since my original, or the only video I have on how I made my Deceit cosplay, things have changed. I obviously, as you can see from the stripes, have gotten a new jacket. The jacket I did not make all myself. I found it on ThreadUp. It's an online thrift store that I absolutely love. And this fits so perfectly, and it looks, it was such a gem of a find for an updated Deceit cosplay, because honestly, I wasn't that thrilled of how that turned out. Fortunately, it has helped some of you, which I am glad, but after wearing it for so long, I'm like, this could be updated a little better. The only downside is it has a few stripes in there, which I'm not, you know, it's not solid dark gray, but it still looks a lot better. Also, I don't know why I decided to do this today, considering it is a very humid day, and I legit took off my pants because it's that hot. But let me show you this jacket, but it just looks like I'm wearing a long dress, so it's fine. Gloves are the same, the hat's the same, and the little cape is the same as well. Also, the technique I used for making Janus's jacket, like, but I used gold, I think? Or I don't know if I used solid yellow. I don't exactly remember, but it's basically the same stuff. And same with these, it's the same thing, I just, you know, replicated on a different jacket. Oh my gosh, it's been so long. I know what I said in the beginning about, you know, not feeling as confident in, you know, cosplays of characters that are my absolute favorite, but right now I think it's also the fact that it's been quite some time since I put on a cosplay, so it does feel nice as well. So now I can finally stop having this video just hang over my head. But you know, new things pop up and unfortunately they get pushed to the front of the line. I hope this guy, there you go, I hope it helped you, hope you guys enjoyed this video. And until next time, I still need to do my Janus inspired theatrical freckles. Hopefully I have some sort of motivation and don't feel like shit tomorrow. Oh my gosh, I need to stop talking. Okay, bye bye.